Today we will be talking about retroperitoneal hematomas and its management. So the retroperitoneal space is a potential anatomical space posterior to the abdominal cavity. For the purposes of trauma, we divide them into three zones: zone 1, zone 2, and zone 3. Zone 1 is central. It is from the hiatus of the aorta and goes towards the bifurcation of the aorta. It contains the aorta, it contains the IVC, it contains duodenum and pancreas. Zone 2 is both on right side and left side. It's basically lateral to zone 1. It contains our kidneys. It also contains the hilar vessels and also the ureter and the ascending and descending colon. Zone 3 is below zone 1. It is the bifurcation of the aorta as it bifurcates into the right and the left internal and external iliac arteries and the veins. It has the distal part of the ureter and the sigmoid colon and the rectum as components. For the purpose of management, we can divide these into two bases of mechanism. If it's a penetrating trauma, zone 1 has to be explored because it's most likely a penetrating trauma coming from the IVC or the aorta. For a penetrating trauma to zone 2, it is also to be explored because it contains major vessels such as the hilar vessels in the renal hilum, or could be penetrating injury to the kidneys as well. For zone 3, if it's a penetrating injury, it's coming from the iliac artery or the iliac vein, so the management is to explore. For blunt trauma, for zone 1 injuries, the management is explore the injury area. For zone 2 and 3, you do not explore for blunt trauma unless you see an expanding hematoma. So in order to make it simple, for penetrating trauma, zone 1, 2, or 3, you explore. For blunt, you only explore for zone 1. You do not explore for zone 2 or 3 unless there is an expanding hematoma.